हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश सोट एंड क्लासेस। एक्सरसाइज 21, गेट रेडी फॉर डिक्टेशन, स्टार्ट। सर, गिवन दैट द इंटेंट वॉज नॉट टू पैकेज द कोड एज ए फ्रेश अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर क्रेडिटर्स एंड क्लेमेंट्स हु डिड नॉट एक्सरसाइज देयर रेमेडी under existing laws within the prescribed limitation period, the committee thought it fit to insert a specific section applying the Limitation Act to the code stop. The relevant entry under the Limitation Act may be on a case-to-case basis stop. It was further noted that the Limitation Act may not apply to applications of corporate applicants as these are initiated by the applicant for its own debts for the purpose of CIRP and are not in the form of a creditor's remedy stop. A perusal of the above would show that considering that the Limitation Act applies only to codes unless made statutorily applicable to tribunals, the committee was of the view that such act should be made to apply to the IBC as well, observing that though the IBC is not a debt recovery law, the trigger being default in payment of debt would render the exclusion of the law of limitation counterintuitive stop. Thus, it was made clear that an application to the IBC should not amount to resurrection of time-barred debts which in any other forum would have been dismissed on the ground of limitation stop. From the above, it is clear that the principle of Section 9 of the Limitation Act is to be strictly adhered to, namely that when time begins to run, it cannot be halted except by a process known to law stop. One question that arises before this court is whether Section 18 of the Limitation Act, which extends the period of limitation depending upon an acknowledgement of debt made in writing and signed by the corporate debtor, is also applicable under Section 238A, given the expression as far as may be governing the applicability of the Limitation Act to the IBC stop. The aforesaid question is no longer valid as two recent judgments of this court have applied the provisions of Section 14 and Section 18 of the Limitation Act to the IBC stop. Thus, in Sheshnath Singh VBD Cooperative Bank Limited Civil Appeal Number 9000 of 2019, after setting out the issues that arose in that case in paragraph 57 and after referring to Section 238A of IBC stop. Similarly, under Section 18 of the Limitation Act, an acknowledgement of present subsisting liability made in writing in respect of any right claimed by the opposite party and signed by the party against whom the right is claimed has the effect of commencing of a fresh period of limitation from the date on which the acknowledgement is signed stop. However, the acknowledgement must be made before the period of limitation expires stop, as observed above section 238A of the IBC makes the provisions of the Limitation Act as far as may be applicable to proceedings before the NCLT and the NCLAT stop. The IBC does not exclude the application of section 6 or 14 or 18 or any other provision of the Limitation Act to proceedings under the IBC in the NCLT stop. All the provisions of the Limitation Act are applicable to proceedings in the NCLT to the extent feasible stop. We see no reason why section 14 or 18 of the Limitation Act 1963 should not apply to proceeding under section 7 or section 9 of the IBC stop. Of course, section 18 of the Limitation Act is not attracted in this case, since the impugned order of the NCLAT does not proceed on the basis of any acknowledgement stop. Nearer home in Lakshmi Path, Surana v. Union Bank of India, a judgment earlier delivered this court after referring to various judgments of this court, including the judgment in Babulal, then held the purport of such observation has been dealt with in the case of Babulal stop. Suffice it to observe that this court had not ruled out the application of section 18 of the Limitation Act to the proceedings under the code if the fact situation of the case so warrants stop. Considering that the purport of section 238A of the code as enacted is clarificatory in nature and being a procedural law had been given retrospective effect, which included application of the provisions of the Limitation Act on case-to-case basis stop. Indeed, the purport of amendment in the code was not to reopen or revive the time-barred debts under the Limitation Act stop. At the same time, accrual of fresh period of limitation in terms of section 18 of the Limitation Act is on its own under that act stop. It will not be a case of giving new lease to time-barred debts under the existing law as such stop. Notably, the provisions of Limitation Act have been made applicable to the proceedings under the code as far as may be applicable stop.